At it and get to the point where we say, can God look at you and say, now I know,
my God,
that you love me?
My God.
You know, can he really say, now I know you love me, I've forsaken everything else,
Jesus,
in my life for you? If it's the very thing I asked for, and if you ask for it back, I give it back. Now I know that you love me. But most people don't want to pay that price. Because if you really do an assessment of yourself in here now, how many of us are reading the Bible every day? Yeah. How many of us are studying and meditating on it day and night? And we were talking about it last night in Bible study. I showed them to him why we have to study and meditate day and night. Because Satan is before God.
That's right.
Day and night. Telling on us. That's what the Bible says in the book of Revelation. He gave John the revelation of showing John. John, this is what the adversary is doing. He's calling y'all out day and night. So that's what we talked about. You talk about God is in hell. Satan's in hell. God, Satan ain't in hell. Satan's between heaven and earth. That'll flip people out. But read your Bible. Same between heaven and earth, because he's talking to God all the time about us. He can't do anything to us without God's permission.
That's right. That's right.
He got to get his permission by what? Talking to God. He's our adversary. Come on. He's the adversary.
Not God.
Come on now. You think about that thing. This thing is serious. So when you see that, you understand more now why God say what? Go boldly. You appreciate Paul more when you start preaching like we did at that funeral.
Yeah.
And you smell the weed. The weed is just covering the whole sanctuary. Wow.
Amen.
You know, you appreciate them cats more now. And how they died, man. You appreciate as matros. You appreciate how they died. Mm-hmm. Man, cats getting thrown in tar.
That's right.
You know, cats getting beheaded.
That's right. Sown or something.
And they knew it was coming, yet they still delivered the word of God. That's what gave me the chill. They knew, hey, they gonna get me eventually, because most of them were too cowardly to go outside of Jerusalem. So I can only hide so long. So eventually I shall get caught. And when I get caught, I know the price that I got to pay. But I love him more than I love me. So I can sit in a house with my lights off.
Yeah.
I can move into a hotel. Jesus. And I can still be at church. And I can still praise God.
Speak, Lord.
Like it ain't nothing. Because I know greater is my reward in heaven.
My God.
Yeah.
So when a lot of people sit there and they make excuses about why they can't, I look at you and say, while I can.
That's right. Right.
Well, they say, show me one that can't. I'll show you one that can. Yeah, it's not many that can, that's willing to be a can. You know, everybody can be a can because it's easy, man. It's easy. It don't cost you nothing to be a can. Dead man can be a can. You know what I mean? So it don't cost you anything to be a can. So why would I affiliate myself? That's why I came up with the thing yesterday. Got a whole new slogan that came to me right yesterday before I went to Bible study. I wish you were there. I know your wife probably told you about it. It just right on. And that's what it says. Champions for Christ, born and bred, champion for Christ till I'm dead. I believe it in my soul.
Yes.
Champion for Christ. And I don't know if I'm dying tomorrow or 80 years from now.
That's right. That's
but
right.
I live with that in my soul.
Yes.
Because I got to believe it. If nobody else believe it, I got to believe
my
it.
My God.
I got to be willing to walk alone.
Yes.
I got to be willing to walk alone, baby. Champion for Christ until I'm dead. You have anything else, man, that you put up on a pedestal like that? Till I die? This is what I'll be doing, Lord, for the remainder of my life. I'll be going out here recruiting and fighting for the kingdom.
Yes.
And I had a champion for Christ by that as a symbolic symbol of who I serve. So when you see it in here, understand what we say too now. And Pastor, I want you to vouch for this. A lot of times I don't have anything against large churches.
Amen.
I don't have anything against large churches. I think the pastors are doing a great job, but a lot of people go to large churches to hide.
That's right. That's right.
They go to hide in the crowd because they don't have to do anything. They've come to the point where they're lethargic with just going to church. I can just go and get out. But God ain't going to let nobody in heaven for perfect attendance.
Jesus. Jesus.
Can't get in heaven for perfect attendance. It takes a little more than that.
Yes, sir.
Jesus.